So make sure to turn off your cell phone if you haven't yet. And we're going to do something today that, at least for me, is pretty uncommon. We're going to start with chanting. And from the chanting, we're going to go into mantra meditation. The mantra, of course, being the equivalent of chanting in your head. And most mantra meditations are not secular, meaning the mantra that I use for chanting is the Nichiren mantra. I use it because my aunt is a very devout Nichiren. And I used to do chanting with the Hare Krishnas, and I've done Vajrayana chanting. And if you ask a Hare Krishna why they chant Hare Krishna, or a Nichiren why they chant Nam-myoho Renge Kyo, and so on, they're going to believe that those words are particularly important, that you couldn't just chant anything, you have to chant properly. I don't know about that. Not to say it's not true, to say I don't really know whether that's true. So I want to take a more secular approach to chanting and mantra. And the secular approach would be, we're going to use the Nichiren chant just because it's easy to remember, and I think it's got kind of a good beat to it. When we go quiet, if you hate the Nichiren mantra, pick some other mantra. What I find interesting about the mantra practice is, in most practices, it's talking to yourself in your head that's the main distraction from practice. When you're doing mantra, it generally drowns out the voice in your head. Like if you're deliberately thinking words, the idiot monologue that's running in there all day about meditation's awesome, I gotta do this all the time, wait, no, I changed my mind, I hate this, can I leave, are people gonna notice, and you know, on and on and on about planning and worrying and fantasizing. You don't get too much of that when you're doing the mantra. So I'm curious to play around with this tonight and see how everybody does with it. So I'm gonna set a timer here for 40 minutes. And if you're following along at, oh, I got the phone. If you're following along at home, I would try, so we're gonna do the first 10 minutes out loud, and then the last 30 we'll do silently. If you're following along at home, do chant out loud if there's not anyone around to be too bothered by it. So the Nichiren chant is Nam-myoho Renge Kyo, where the closest English phoneme is an R sound, like Ren. So I'll chant it after a couple times through, it should sound familiar, and I hope you all join in. And the idea is, like if you go to church or synagogue and there's the like call and response, often people are kind of, you know, whispering half dead. Chanting should be like from the heart. So it's okay to get nice and loud. We always hear the neighbors, they'll get to hear us for once. I'll go like this. Nam-myoho Renge Kyo, 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 Nam-myoho Nam-myoho Renge Kyo, Nam-myoho Renge Kyo, Myoho Renge Kyo, Nam-myoho 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 Nam-myoho Renge-kyo, 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 Nam-myoho Renge-kyo. Ho renge kyo nam myo 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 ho renge kyo ho renge kyo nam myo 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 ho renge 겨 남묘호 렌게교 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 렌게교 남묘호 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 렌게교 남 호호 렌게교 남묘호 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 렌게교 남 남묘호 렌게교 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 남 남묘호 렌게교 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 남 And we'll sit quietly for the remainder. I mean, I won't really do any guiding. We'll just keep repeating the mantra. If you're new at this, commit that any evaluation, do you like mantra meditation? Does it work? Does it work for you? Is tabled until the bell rings. So no, the bell rings, our only business is repeating the mantra. Feel free to switch to a different one if there's one you know and prefer. In our standard Theravada language here, the mantra should be the object of attention. So the goal isn't just to say it, but to listen to it, focus on it. The closest thing we do in Theravada is probably in American Theravada, is the metta, the Brahmavihara practice. But this is different in that when you're trying to focus on the meaning, the intention. Here it's actually just the sound.